So what do you do? Where are you from? Do you come here often? How do you know your friend? You probably heard these boring interview standard questions a million times. And what I want to do in this video is I want to share with you how you can break out of these boring questions, but not only that, how you could use these questions to your advantage to come up with more fun and more interesting conversation that actually attracts women rather than boring them to tears and turning them off. So what I'm gonna do in this video is share with you some techniques that I teach on my weekend long programs to help guys use these questions to their favor. And let's jump right into the four things that you could do. And the first thing that you could do, and I'll give you a lot of examples here as well. The first thing that you could do is to answer this question for yourself. This is a huge tip that can start to get a lot of juice out of your conversation. It's a very easy and simple thing to do, but it can definitely have a huge, huge impact. It's an awesome tip. So for example, let's use the question, where are you from? So somebody asks, where are you from? Or let's say you ask it, right? You're talking to a girl and you say, where are you from? She says, I'm from New York. Now, instead of going right on to the next question, that's a big mistake guys make, because they just go right on to the next question. You want to now answer this question for yourself. Not only answer it, but give more information and give a good story. So if I ask a girl where she's from and she says Texas, you know, I could ask her more and stuff like that, but after she's done talking about it, I'll say, you know, I'm originally from the East Coast, and the East Coast is like X, Y, and Z, and I came out here because of X, Y, and Z, and what I love about this city is X, Y, and Z, and the people here are friendly and nice, and it's a good culture, it's a very livable city. So now I could take that question that I asked, and rather than just getting her one-word response from it, I'm now answering the question myself, setting a precedence for sharing information and also giving value in the interaction. This is a huge tip. If you do this one thing, it'll have a huge impact on your conversations to use these boring questions to your advantage. Now, the second thing you could do with these questions is turn them into a guess. So let's take the question of what do you do, right? So rather than just asking a girl, what do you do, which is a boring question, why don't you shoot a guess at her? So if she looks really professional, you could say, you know, you look like you have a professional vibe to you. You're probably in sales. And she could say yes or no and explain what she does, but just the act of making a read or a suggestion and then guessing what she does, you're just going to stand out a little bit from the other guys, and to be much more of a fun thing to do rather than you just asking where you're from or what do you do. You know, making an actual guess. You can do the question where you're from. You look like you grew oranges growing up. You're probably a Florida girl. I could totally tell, right? Whatever it may be. You're just going to make a guess rather than asking the question. It's something a little different, breaks out of the normal conversation, and gets you a couple more points rather than just being like every single other guy that she's talking to. Now, these next two things to do are my absolute favorite, and these are where you're gonna add a joking and a humorous element into your conversations. So the third thing that you could do, which I like, is to not only make a guess, but make a joking guess. And I kind of did it with the example before, but you can definitely go as far out as you want with these. And look, if you can't come up with these on the spot, then take some time, either pause this video or do it after you're done watching the video, and just write some of these down and come up with some funny things to say and do, right? Let me just give you lines and stuff that I came up with. Use your creativity and come up with some yourself as well. So the third thing that I like to do is make a joking guess. So if you're guessing what she does, you could say something like, you know, if she looks fit, you could say, you look really fit, or you like the strong woman in the local circus or something like that. Or, you know, you look like a girl who could probably cook. I bet you're like a Betty Crocker on YouTube or something like that. And I'm just thinking of some of these off the top of my head. I didn't really put any thought into these examples. But the whole point is to just come up with something kind of out of left field that's a funny joke, get her laughing a bit, and then she's going to answer the question anyway. But like I said before, you're going to get more points by just throwing something humorous out there. And what you're doing is throwing a cog in the wheel. You're kind of breaking up this boring interaction and standing out as a guy. And the fourth thing that I love to do to break out of these boring standard interview questions is to give a joking response when she asks me the question. Another thing you could do too is not only give a joking response when she asks you the question, but you could ask this question yourself and then respond to your own question with your answer, but give a joking answer. So let's take what we said before, right? What do you do? So she could ask you what you do, and then you could give a humorous response. Or you could ask what she does, talks about, and then say, yeah, I'm actually, and then tell your joking response. You know, you could say that, you know, some old school ones were like, you know, I work at we have a fast food chain down here called Whataburger, you know, so like I'm the fry technician at Whataburger, you know, disposable lighter repair man. I'm an ass model, you know, I'm a stand-in for I was a stand-in for the second Magic Mike movie, you know, I'm a male dancer, I'm an escort, I'm a blow-up doll tester, you know, I'm a whatever it may be, right? So you could come up with some funny type of response to some joking type of thing out of left field, right? You could say you're a professional scooter racer for a NASCOOT, you could call, you know, we came up with that on my last program. You could say that you're an Instagram selfie coach. You could say that you're a plus-sized Instagram model. You could say that, you know, you're a Snapchat filter maker. You know, you could, the possibilities are endless. You can come up with as many of these as you want. You could definitely use the ones that I give you if you want, but, you know, I encourage you to try to come up with some of these on your own. And these are awesome. And what you could also do too is once you have these, right, and you have one of those kind of one-liner things that I gave you, come up with details for them, right? Why would it be funny to be a selfie coach? You know, why? Because you tell girls the right angles to use. You tell them the right lighting to use. You tell them to turn their chin down so the chin doesn't come out. Turn their arm out so that the fat on the arm doesn't show. You tell them what filters to use, you know, what colors to get the most likes. You know, come up with details for some of these things. They're extremely fun to use. They're really funny, and they can breathe such life into your conversation. So that one is definitely my favorite of the four to use. You know, back in the day, we were told to avoid these questions at all costs and don't use them. But what I found is these questions come up whether you try to avoid them or not. The girl's gonna ask them. So I'd rather be prepared for these questions, have some humorous, funny things to say, and also have your own responses for them. You know, this is a big thing that we work on all weekend long on my boot camp, you know, coming up with things to talk about and things to say. So definitely take this video, but use it, pause it, and do some exercises and come up with some of these things for yourself. Let me know how it's going for you if you enjoyed the video. And when you're ready, I'll have the next video queued up for you. And feel free to check out any of my other videos that I have for you here on YouTube.